let me start my questioning under the seven-minute rule. You both have an extraordinary background in having served in the Federal Public Defender's Office representing indigents and people who often struggle in our system of justice. I think we know that we're engaged in a national conversation now about justice, long overdue. And it's raised questions about law enforcement, questions about sentencing, questions about incarceration. It really calls to question the agenda of this committee, the Senate Judiciary Committee, on the criminal justice side. You've got a special perspective that you bring to this that many nominees don't, in light of what you have done with your life. I don't want you to address any case or any specific situation, but I'd like for your observations, because you've spent such a big part of your lives. It goes back to what Langston Hughes once said, spend such a long part of your, big part of your life for those who would say, life for me ain't been no crystal stair. Folks who, black, brown, poor defendants who seeking representation in a system that seems to them just overwhelming and fundamentally unfair in some cases. What would be your general thoughts, without any specific case in mind, about justice in America today and how you've seen it and how it's changed in your time? Judge Jackson?
Thank you, Senator. I had the privilege of serving as a federal public defender, assistant federal public defender in Washington, D.C., I think it was some 16 years ago. And as part of that experience, I, as you say, represented people. I represented them in the appellate division of my office. So all of my clients were convicted. And I think that the insights that one gains from that kind of professional experience really can be very helpful in future endeavors, especially if you go into the judicial service, as I have. And I can give you a concrete example. When I worked with my clients as a defender, my job was to talk with them and to try to get their help to identify errors, things that had gone wrong in their trial proceedings so that I could raise them on appeal. And one of the things that I noticed that I was really struck by was how little they could help me with that project. Most of my clients didn't really understand what had happened to them. They'd just been through the most consequential proceeding in their lives, and no one really explained to them what they were supposed to expect, so they didn't know where things might have gone wrong. And I remember that experience from all those years ago when I became a trial judge. One of the things that I do now is I take extra care to communicate with the defendants who come before me in the courtroom. I speak to them directly and not just to their lawyers. I use their names. I explain every stage of the proceeding because I want them to know what's going on. And when I have to sentence someone, and I've sentenced more than 100 people to date, I always tell them, I explain to them, this is why your behavior was so harmful to society that Congress thought that it had to be made a crime. And I say, this is why I, as the judge, believe that you have to serve these consequences for your decision to engage in criminal behavior. And I think that's really important for our entire justice system, because it's only if people understand what they've done, why it's wrong, and what will happen to them if they do it again, that they can really start to rehabilitate. So there is a direct line from my defender service to what I do on the bench, and I think it's beneficial.
Thank you. Ms. Jackson-Akumi, I noted in my introduction that you made the extraordinary career move from private practice to the Federal Defenders Program for 10 years, I believe, that you served there. So I'd like you to consider the same question I just asked Judge Jackson, and in the process, perhaps you'd comment on demeanor and temperament of judges?
Certainly, Senator. Thank you for the question. I can think of two observations from my time serving as a federal public defender that I think will bode well for me in serving the public as a judge, if confirmed. First is the importance of listening and the importance of being heard. It's actually something I learned well before I went to law school from my mother when she served as a judge. She often talked about the importance of letting people make sure they've been heard by the court, because it's easier for people to accept even adverse rulings by the court when they at least know they've been heard. That's built into our system of due process, which involves an opportunity to be heard. A cousin to that is listening. I gained an extraordinary amount of experience listening as a federal public defender, listening to the views of opposing counsel, prosecutors, about their views of the case, to find out where we might negotiate, where we might find common ground, listening to the stories of my clients to understand why and how they came to be standing before the court and what their fears and questions were, and listening very carefully to the questions that piercing trial judges and appellate judges were asking me about the case. And so being a federal public defender sharpened my listening skills, and I know that even though the job of advocate and judge are completely different, one skill that should translate well for me is that of listening, because circuit judges, above all, must listen to the parties before they even attempt to reach a reasoned decision. The other observation from my time in the criminal justice system as an advocate is the importance of setting aside personal convictions, personal opinions. At the Federal Defender Program, we represented whoever walked in the door, charged with whatever crime, so long as they needed an attorney, so long as they were poor and working class and could not afford an attorney. That's what the Constitution and the case law dictated. With each and every case, I had to put aside any personal opinions I had about my client and any personal opinions I had about what they were accused of or the behavior, and represent them zealously in the courts. And again, even though the role of advocate and judge are completely different, that is one similarity. Like a federal public defender, a judge has to set aside their personal opinions and their personal convictions in decision making. Thank you.
Thank you. Senator Grassley?
Yeah.